The Singer by William Billington. A poet's birth is a people's boon. A singer there dwelt in a city of yore, a populous city and proud, and his spirit was love, and his speech lit with lore, but bashful and timid he trembled before the gaze of the gaping crowd. And he sang like a seraph at heaven's blue door, and his aim and his hope were to sing and to soar, like a lark in the heart of a cloud. That city grew rich with the sound of his praise, and the wealthy, soon every one, seemed hanging with rapture and love on his lays, and would wish him Godspeed, ever fanning the blaze of his fame which so brightly had shone. And they called him our singer and poet always, little deeming how fleeting and few were his days, and how soon would the singer be gone. He wove in his life with the woof of his lay, and that good city gave him its breath, its emptiest homage, the poet's sure pay, from its loftiest spire in the sun's golden ray, he suspended an evergreen wreath, far out of the reach of those sleepless and grey destroyers, old time, and his kinsman decay, and too high for the arrows of death. One morning, as wont, when the world had awoke, and the people were praying for news, the blue-bending heavens were dimmed by the smoke, which in dark-wreathing columns rose threatening to choke the pure air from a forest of flues. On the ear of that city a rumour there broke, like the autumn wind sighing through forests of oak, 'twas the death of that son of the muse. On clay-cold ground a corpse was found, its garments fringed with frost, pale golden tressed, white lips compressed, eyes blue and half unclosed. When did he die? The quidnuncs cry. How did he come by this ill? What was the cause? Nobody knows. The world wags merrily still. Yes, merrily moved this old world with him, until strangers came there from afar, as out of the east unto Bethlehem, in the days of King Herod, the wise men came, thither led by the light of its star. Some kingdoms did cross, others oceans did stem, for the honour of kissing his garments hem, whose glory time never should mar. That city then draped it in mourning most deep, and said, since our light which has shone, like a midnight lamp from a castle steep, for the guidance of travellers bound by that keep, through the desert where path there is none, are faded too soon, it is meet we should weep, for alas, many ages may over us sweep, nor behold such a luminous one. Our bard was our brightest and daintiest dower, but the richest robe soonest will soil. Oh, that we had but the magical power to rekindle our lamp, even but for 1 hour, whatever the cost of the toil. It should flame on the top of our regalest tower, secure from the wind, from the wintry shower, and the storm, nor be stinted of oil. Thus ever the Christ hath been crucified, our chalice of joy ever split. Our hearts are with evil so strongly allied, until they through the curtains of death are descried, our gods must be branded with guilt. The grave yawns before thee, deep-throated and wide, sweet poet enthroned on the heavenward side, sitteth fame, freely choose which thou wilt.